We have watched as our sport has lost credibility with fans. We cannot be silent any longer.
Honesty, integrity,
fair play,
accountability.
Putting the athlete first.
It's going to bring our sport into the new millennium.
It's a new season bringing new changes. Two-time world champions Jue Zhen and Hongbo Zhao look to dominate the field with their speed, power, and artistry. Russia's Tatmianina and Marinin are in the hunt, hoping to prove that they have what it takes to be the best. Canadians Annabelle Langlois and Patrice Arquette are eager to showcase their talent, while reigning world champion Evgeny Plushenko is unmatched, a powerhouse striving for perfection. Defending Skate Canada champion Takeshi Honda, impressive choreography and unique style, can he retain his title? It all starts here. It's a new season of skating, and it's next on TSN. With the lights of downtown Toronto off in the distance, we're about 30 kilometers to the west in Mississauga, site of the 30th anniversary of the MasterCard Skate Canada International from the Hershey Center. 30 years ago, Skate Canada was held for the first time in Calgary, and since then it's become a fixture on the skating calendar, kind of the unofficial kickoff to the season, and we're glad to have you with us for another season of skating. Hi, everybody, I'm Dave Randorf. It is a season of change, and the biggest one has to do with the way this sport is now judged. A brand new judging system designed to take the onus off of the judges and put directly onto the shoulders of the skaters. It's a complete departure from what you're used to, but we're going to do our very best to explain it to you over the next couple of hours. Some more changes to tell you about, and one brand new one today, an announcement from four-time world champion Alexei Yagudin. Today announces that he's retiring from competition, moving on to pursue new interests. Also won gold at the Olympics in Salt Lake City. He will be honored here at one of his favorite events, Skate Canada. He'll be honored on Sunday, and we'll bring that to you as part of our coverage. When the field for this event was announced, it included this guy. Elvis Stoiko was considering coming back for another season of competition, but about a month ago, he decided that his game was not where it needed to be, and he has hung up the skates, and this time for good. No Elvis in the building this week, and you will not see Bourne and Kratz either. The 10-time Canadian champs, we knew they were retiring from competition, but just recently they announced they're going to skate a few more exhibitions this season, and that will be it. Bourne and Kratz will split, and we won't see those two together again anytime soon. So lots of news on and off the ice. For more, let's throw it over across the ice to Rod Black, Debbie Wilkes, and Tracy Wilson, guys.
Well, thank you, Dave. Happy New Year, everyone, to all you skating fans. It's a new season, whole new season, whole new judging system. And Tracy and Debbie, you both had a chance to see it in action last week at Skate America. It's still a test for the skating world. Thumbs up or thumbs down?
Oh, definitely thumbs up for me. I got to tell you, here for the first time in history, I think skaters are being judged exactly what they do on the ice. It doesn't matter where you're from. It doesn't matter how big your name is, how many medals you've won. And I think another great thing is that viewers better come into the building leaving a lot of things out. Forget 6.0, forget ordinals or placements, and that's just the beginning.
And that's probably the only drawback that I can find to this system at this point. It is a complex system. It helps if you're good in math. But I think once you understand it, it makes total sense, and it begs the question, what took them so long? The other thing I really like about this system is at Skate America, it got two thumbs up from both the skaters and the coaches, and that's what really matters.
Skating fans in this building at the Hershey Center had a chance this afternoon to see it in operation for the first time. The compulsory dance is now complete. Navka Kostomarov of Russia lead the way.
They are the second ranked team in the world, finished fourth last year, and this new system definitely favored them in the compulsory dance. They're sitting just ahead of the Bulgarians, Denkova and Stavinsky, who are in second place, and the top Canadian team at this competition skated quite well in the compulsory dance. They're sitting in fourth place. But what you will see now with the marks that these skaters received, you'll see bigger scores, higher marks. And here you'll see the total for the compulsory dance. In the old system, that total would have been dropped, a place value given. Now these marks count and they carry them over into each phase of the competition.
Might be a little confusing, so let's give you a little orientation, shall we, so you can wrap your head around the new code of points system.
The new judging system is a revolutionary step forward in the judging of figure skating, and simply put, the skater with the most points wins. Programs are still scored in two segments. The first, technical elements, and the second, presentation components. For the technical mark, every element from lifts to jumps to spins to footwork to death spirals has a base value depending on its level of difficulty. For instance, a triple axel is worth 7.5 points, while a triple flip is worth 5.6. During the program, judges will evaluate each element within a range of -3 to +3. -3 if the skater falls, to +3 for a superior jump. The grade of execution is then added or subtracted from the base value. The sum of all performed elements together with the grade of execution will form the total element score. At the end of the program, average point scores are used, but the highest and lowest marks are dropped, ensuring that inconsistency in marks do not affect the results. Also, at the conclusion of the program, judges give 5 marks for presentational aspects of the performance: skating skills, transitions, performance execution, choreography, and interpretation. Again, the computer randomly selects the judges' marks, discards high and low, and averages the remainder to arrive at 1 mark, the total competition score. Scores for each of the skaters' programs, for instance their short and long, are then added together, and the skater with the highest score wins.
All right, you got it? I know it sounds a little bit confusing, but it may be a little bit like diving or gymnastics now, based more on merit than demerit.
Well, if the viewer is anything like me, after Skate America, my head was huge the first day. Then I settled down a little bit. The important thing to remember is good skating is still good skating.
And what we noticed at Skate America is that even though this system is new, it's already coming across on the ice that the skaters are now paying more attention to their skating quality, the spins, the footwork, which is meaning more entertaining and exciting programs.
No more ordinals. You still can have sixes, they just don't mean the same as they once did. When we come back, it's the Paris Short Program at the MasterCard Skate Canada International.
I think this is going to be the pair of the year, Isabel Rousseau and Lloyd Eisler.
Exceptional star lift with a one-arm entry, no assistance from Isabel at all, rotating over into a one-arm overhead. There's no question there's enormous potential here.
That was 1988 back in Thunder Bay. Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler beginning their ascent to what would become a world championship years down the road. And this event has spawned a lot of great skaters, a lot of great pairs teams, Canadians included, of course. Here is the field of competitors tonight in Mississauga. And the first showdown, Debbie Wilkes, of the season between the top two ranked teams in the world, although the number one ranked team right now seems to have the huge edge. And it goes back to Washington and to last season, Shannon Chow.
No question the Chinese are leading the way, but I would definitely caution against underestimating the Russian team of Totmianina and Marinin. They have really read the rule book on this new code of points, and they have made some tremendous changes, as have many of the Canadian teams. We are represented by three outstanding young teams here. And there's a look at the rest of the field.
So the big question is, how does the code of points play into pair skating right now? Is there strategy involved? Is it going to be different? Over the last couple of years, we've watched the first few moments, the first element really for a lot of teams in that the side-by-side jumps. Are they still as imperative as they once were?
No question, they're very important. But when you look at the seven other elements as well, there is much more importance placed now. More evenly, the program must be well balanced. The judges will be looking for complicated entries and exits to things and multiple positions when it comes to the lifts.
So here we go. The skating season in Canada begins with the silver medalists from Washington at the World Championships, young Tatiana Tatmianina, Maxim Maranin.
Our next skaters represent Russia, Tatiana Tatmianina and Maxim Maranin,
who again are on a collision course this season with Shuaya Shen and Hongbo Zhao. The short program.
Well, remember last year that Tatiana and Maxim had won everything, including having beaten the Chinese prior to Washington. They're looking to make the changes that are necessary later in the year to get them on the top of the podium. Fabulous individual skaters. Tremendous use of edge work. This is the footwork section. Variety of positions and turns, levels. Gaining speed for their first big pair element, the throw triple loop. Strong and confident with a beautiful reverse entry. Also clean side-by-side triple toes. Next up, a planned double twist. This has been one of their weakest elements in the past. Still slightly lopsided in the split. Judges will be looking to see a balance in the legs. And the lift, bit awkward, looked like a bit of a struggle, lost a lot of speed on the landing.
Season, of course, you see some of the rust from the off season, although there really isn't an off season anymore. These teams, however, peak towards the Worlds and the Grand Prix final. Still some work to do, though, for this team, Tatmianina and Maranin. We have seen them skate better. A couple of shaky moments.
Shaky moments, yes, but tremendous control and originality in some of the spinning positions. The final pair spin was complicated and very elegant.
So up next, we get our first look at the new code of point system. You ready for this?
I'm ready.
Explanation ready. And their marks to come at the MasterCard Skate Canada International, and also Canadians Putnam and Wirtz from Mississauga in the Hershey Center. Straight up on TSN. Tatiana Tatmianina and Maxim Maranin of Russia. They have skated in the shadows of Berezhnaya Sikhorlidze for so many years. They are the top-ranked team in Russia and one of the top-ranked teams in the world.
This, however, was not a particularly inspired performance, a new program, but one of the hottest and best elements they did was a beautiful throw triple loop. Very elegant, beautiful style, always positions front and center in their mind. What does it look like? Some of the other elements were a bit labored. They looked to feel a little awkward, maybe fatigue. Always that first entrance into the rink competitively. It's a bit of a, your head goes a little crazy.
Well, also, you're trying to break open the new program and unveil it. So here's how it works. Technical elements marks and program components, marks, you add them together for your short program total.
Technical elements are all about those eight required elements, and if they were skated well, what their base value would add up to. The program components, more like the former artistic marks.
And again, top and bottom marks are removed. Right now, Tatmianina and Marinin, those are the marks. That is the score to beat. 67-4.
Elizabeth Putnam and Sean Wirtz.
Here was a team that created quite a stir last year. New team last season. This is only their fourth competition together. Elizabeth Putnam and Sean Wirtz. They were third in Canada at their first nationals together. They represent one of the pairs teams of the future, and maybe the future is right now for Putnam and Wirtz.
And a bit like Tatmianina and Marinin, Liz and Sean have that exquisite look of elegance and beauty. The body always perfectly stretched. First element, the double twist. Not very high. Spread eagles into side-by-side triple salchows. Beautiful. Look at that unison. To their throw. This one is salchow. Hand-to-hand lift. To gain difficulty in the base mark, it must change position. This one was fairly basic, but moves beautifully into the footwork section, beginning with a nice piece that interweaves, a one-foot section here, all adding to the level of difficulty.
Start somewhere, you know. Remember those pictures we showed you of Brasseur and Eisler at their first Skate Canada? Maybe down the road we'll be saying the same thing about these two.
Very bright future.
Putnam and Wirtz, their first Skate Canada. Their first short program of free skate still to come. Crowd loved it. They're very happy. We'll see what the judges have to say when we come back to Mississauga at the MasterCard Skate Canada International. The national championships, and keep in mind, there will not be a defending champion this year with Jacinthe LaRivière and Lenny Faustino splitting up as a partnership. So a Canadian title is up for grabs, and maybe Putnam and Wirtz might just grab it.
And now with the new Coda Point system here being tested at the Grand Prix, we're seeing a lot more emphasis on spins, something that skaters have tended to maybe not do the best amount of homework on. But Liz and Sean certainly had this one nailed beautifully fast, incredibly together. The lift was a bit of a struggle. That's a very tough entrance, the hand-to-hand lift. Then it goes into more like an overhead, but it, generally speaking, quite simple.
when you get to look at some of the more complicated lifts you'll see later in the event.
And of course, there's Christy Wirtz, a former Canadian champion. She's the aunt of Sean. They are really like the Sutter family of skating.
And one of their coaches, Chris and Christy, spend a lot of time with them. The main coach is Chris's brother, Paul.
56.04, not near Tontianina and Marinin, so right now they
the total
are
segment score for their program is
11.2 points back of them, and currently in third place, the Canadian team of Putnam and Wirtz.
This gives them a ranking of third place. Our next competitors representing Poland, Dorota Zagorska and Mariusz Sudek.
Well, they represent Poland. If you've been following skating over the years, you know these two. They've been around. They won a bronze medal at the World Championships in 1999, and I guess they also are part Canadian now because they train in the Montreal area. They've been training there for the last 6 months. Dorota Zagorska and Mariusz Sudek. Team known for its great ability in the lift department.
Husband and wife team training now with Richard Gauthier. One of Richard's comments about them was, they're a couple off the ice. My job is going to be to show the audience that they're a couple on the ice as well. And we're seeing tremendous improvement from this team, who thought last year they were really finished. Nice start with a throw triple loop. Side by side triple toes. Timing a little better. In the past, those jumps have been seriously out of unison. This lift coming up begins with an upside down cartwheel, flip up, watch the changes, one, two, three, and a flip dismount, one-handed.
Nobody in the world can do it like them. The Chinese team's good. Zagorska and Shuda, tremendous lifters.
And here into the death spiral, an unusual leg over the head into the entry, change of hands, and out in a spread eagle. Again, all adding to the level of difficulty, increases the base mark.
Should be happy with that. Zagorska and Sudek, Polish champions, now living and training in Canada, trying to get back to the podium at the World Championships. Still have two Canadian teams to come, including Langlois and Arquetto. And the marks for the Polish pairs champions after this. Along with coach Richard Gauthier, who of course was the first time coach for Saleh and Pelche at one time, and the Polish champions Zagorska and Sudek.
Dave, difficult entry from the back edge into the side-by-side combination spins. They lost a little bit of unison on the changeover, but got back together for the entrance. But what I loved was the innovation, particularly here going into the back outside death spiral. Hard enough, the back outside. Most pair skaters consider it the most difficult of all the death spirals. But they included a change of arm position and then an unusual exit as well, all adding to the level of difficulty, therefore a higher base mark.
So again, give us the Qualls notes here of what exactly you're seeing and what the judges are thinking here. And a degree of difficulty, I think, plays into everything that you see now.
Absolutely everything. The better you do an element, the higher your marks. The worse you do an element, you may still get the base mark, but the judges must deduct from that base mark, add them all up, and you got the final short program total.
61.54. About 5.5 behind the Russians right now. Let's go backstage to Dave Randorf.
And I am with Elizabeth Putnam and Sean Wirtz. And seeing as you are the first skaters to come my way tonight, I've got to start right off the bat by asking you, Sean, about your, I guess, reaction to the new system that's in place here tonight.
I think most of the skaters here that I've talked to, that I've spoken with, really enjoy the new system. They like the way it's set up. As skaters, you really get to understand where your marks are coming from, where you see you can improve, and where you're lacking in the points. So it's really good.
Let's talk a little bit about the performance. And skating here at Skate Canada, Elizabeth, must be a real thrill. Your first Grand Prix event and a special one.
Yeah, it's really special to be here at Skate Canada with the Canadian fans. And we have lots of friends and family here, so it's great support. And we skated the best short we've done all year, so we're really pleased with ourselves and we're happy the way it's going.
Well, it was nice. Congratulations on that. And we'll look forward to a year-long program tomorrow night.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
We'll take another break from Mississauga. Still to come, more pairs, including the world champs from China.
So even backstage, the skaters looking at how this judging system works. And Zagorska and Szudek of Poland currently in second place. Like their ranking so far, if they can figure it out. Tatmianina and Marinin, leaders right now. And you see Putnam and Wirtz, they are in fourth place. And here are the world champions. Zhuya Shen Hongpo Zhao of China.
Our next competitors representing China, Zhuya Shen and Hongpo Zhao.
For so long, skating behind Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sigerlitze and Jamie Sele and David Pelche, with those two teams now in the pro ranks, this is their time. And I was looking at their ages before this skate. They could be a force for a long time. They're only in their early 20s.
That's the plan. What sets this team apart is their ability to skate as one. Without looking, they reach, the partner is there. It's like they skate in the same bubble. Their first element, throw triple loop. Now the side-by-side triple toe jump. Slightly off in timing, but both jumps clean. Great variation on that lift.
Thank you.
Dakota point system. Use real originality and creativity moving from one element to the next. Rarely do you see just plain old skating. Whoa, bad loss of unison there. Their best trick, the twist. Watch it fly. Lateral in position, but they will lose marks for the uneven split prior to the rotation.
Joya Shen and Hongbo Zhao, eight-time Chinese champions, world champions in Washington, world champions in Nagano. Try to make it three in a row, and this is their time right now. Very difficult team to top, showing maybe some early season rust. We'll see what the judges have to say after this from Mississauga and TSN. This is the era now of Shuaya Shen and Hongbo Zhao, two-time world pairs champions, looking forward perhaps to the next Winter Olympics and also to the next event on the Grand Prix circuit in China, first ever.
And let's hope they begin the short program there just like they did here with a spectacular throw triple loop, a base value of 5.0, which the judges would likely give an extra 2 points for its grade of execution. Here, the twist was beautiful and high, but lopsided on the split going in. Maybe kind of a balance for the judges there. A spectacular move, but not without fault.
Let's see how the difficult elements play out and the score plays out. Again, that total element score is really the technical element score, the program component similar to artistic impression or presentation.
Looking at the kinds of transitions, choreography, interpretation, and performance.
And they are the leaders. The world champion, 68.76, 1.5 ahead of Tatmianina and Marinin heading to the free skate. And two Canadian teams to come, including Annabelle Langlois and Patrice Arquette. They are up next from the Hershey Center in Mississauga on Canada's sports leader, TSN. And here at the Hershey Center, on the ice, Valerie Marcoux and Craig Bunton of Canada. Fourth at the Nationals last year.
Now training in Montreal with Richard Gauthier, who has made tremendous improvement for this team. They're skating with more power and much more confidence. Changing to one arm in the overhead, to a spinning platter. Original dismount. Good throw triple loop. Entry on the side-by-side spin gives it a higher level of difficulty too. Little early season jitters from Craig. Couple of stumbles. lot of good and interesting changes in the paraspin.
But we'll see where the judges rank them, and we can talk more about how those stumbles and maybe an over-rotation affects that total mark now when we come back and, again, explore this new code of points judging system they are implementing this year. And also Canada's top-ranked pairs team is next. You only see the three scores on your screen now. You don't see all of the marks from the respective judges, but they are all still there. Tell me what they're doing now, how this all combines to get this total score.
A technical specialist who is not part of the judging panel identifies the elements and their level of difficulty. From there, the judges do their part. On tonight's panel, there are 10 of them. The computer randomly selects seven. Only seven marks are used. The top and bottom of those seven are thrown out. The remaining five are averaged to come up with the grade of execution for a particular element.
Thank goodness we're in the computer age. Although they apparently can do this by hand.
Well, it's certainly still new. Let's remember that this is still just a test for the Grand Prix series and the Grand Prix final. A lot of bugs still to be worked out, a few things to be tweaked, I think, but boy, are we ever on the right track.
And for the most part, again, you look down
the
what we've seen
four,
so far here tonight, and you cannot look at any of the decisions and say that that's wrong. Everything has been pretty much falling into order the way it should.
Well, and interestingly, Valerie and Craig will lose a fair amount of points off their base values because of the problem in the side-by-side triple toe. The judges will look at the lowest common denominator as if both skaters had stepped out of the jump, a minus two on that element. Also stumbles in the footwork would be fairly costly.
49.72, almost a full 20 points behind the leaders, Xuea Shen and Hongbo Zhao. What I like about this thing now is that you're looking at points, and if you get to the free skate, you just have to look at one total, and the team or the skater with the most points wins.
Fairly straightforward.
Final pairs team of the evening here in the short program, Canada's top-ranked pairs team, Annabelle Langlois and Patrice Arquette. Very disappointed at the national championships when they did not win the Canadian title. However, they were elated when they broke into the top five at the World Championships in Washington. A team that got off to a great start last year in the early season in the Grand Prix circuit and would like to do the same right here tonight.
On the world scene, they still have a big battle. The four teams ahead of them are still there, but what this team has that some of the others ahead of them have not are tremendous programs, brilliant choreography, great musicality, and you put the jumps in and the other elements, great team. Starting with the toe triple salto. Side triple toe loops. Very strong. Watch all the connecting steps, too. For the first time, judges are rewarding it. Changing position and hold at the top of the lift. Landing on an unusual back inside edge. But watch the step sequence. Dancers, beware. Very closely together. air combination spin. Fast and clean.
And another great start to the season for Annabelle Langlois and Patrice Arquette. 2 years ago at Skate Canada, they burst onto the scene with a third-place finish. Last year, they finished second at Skate America, then third at Skate Canada. Keep in mind, the top two teams here had some bobbles and were a little shaky. Langlois and Arquette looked good. Crowd loved them. We'll see what the judges say next.
Technical score for this performance is 33.
Here are the marks for Annabelle Langlois and Patrice Arquette. 33.4 for technical elements, close to the Russians and Chinese, but they still are a couple of points behind. In fact, they will head to the free skate a full 4.6 points back of Shen and Zhao. So Langlois and Arquette, the Canadians, are in third place. 64.12. Does that fall in line, what you've seen so far with the rankings?
Yeah, I would say that certainly the top three teams, even the top four teams, were very, very solid and out there way in front of everybody else. I liked what I saw. I thought the skaters were really performing well and doing new things, trying new things, going for difficulty.
Putnam and Wirtz, who competed in Skate America last week, they currently are in sixth as we head to tomorrow night's free skate here in Mississauga. Let's go downstairs to Dave now with the leading Canadians.
Yeah, we're sitting here in the Kiss and Cry where the marks were just handed out. It's interesting, isn't it, this new format? It brings a whole new element to this area.
Yeah, it does. It's very hard, I think, for us right now because we're looking at the marks and usually, you know, you see 5.7 and you're like, oh, that's pretty good. But right now we see, what, 27 point something, and I'm like, I don't know what that means, but...
What do you think, Patrice?
About the system?
Yeah.
It's pretty good. It's a little bit hard to see for a first competition, and it's our first short program of the year. But I think it's good. It's a good thing. And I think along the way, during the competition, we'll see more the little detail that we can see like a 5.7 or 5.8 or 5.6. We'll see a little bit more on Mars, but I think it's very good right now.
And it's a great start here at home in a very important event. Tell me what you thought of the skate tonight, Annabelle.
Well, we did a stupid mistake with the side-by-side spin. You know, the side-by-side spin is something we hardly ever miss in practice. So it's something, for us, it's almost like missing a jump or going, oh, why, right? But it was pretty good. I mean, the crowd seemed to love the program, and that's what we really wanted for them to approve of our new style this year. So
I think they definitely did that, and I'm sure they're looking forward to approving more tomorrow night. Good luck to you then.
Thank you.
Back upstairs, guys. Rod?
Thank you, Dave. You know, I guess one of the best things that might have happened to that team is that they did not win the national championship last year, because it seems they've got angrier and hungrier, and they've gotten better with each performance.
I think you're right. They have clearly defined what it is they want out of skating, where they want to go, and the kind of mark that they want to make. They were pretty terrific tonight. They had a brand new program. The long is also brand new, so we'll have a look at that tomorrow night. Here in the short program, they were very strong in every element. They seemed to enjoy all the transitions. The skating skills were excellent. Here on the opening throw, triple salchow, what confidence, as if they were skating on silk.
I know a lot of you seeing all the judges' marks and the ordinals that we won't see anymore, and the six zeros and the ranking out of that. But for the skaters, I know you only see the three marks, but there really is some good feedback from the judging system that they get right after every event, isn't there?
Yes, and you should go to the ISU website, because you will see every judge's mark. And the whole thing is very clear, but we need practice. Like Annabelle and Patrice, what does it mean?
Well, it means they're in third heading to tomorrow night's free skate, for what it's worth. And when we come back, it's the men. But here tonight, Canada's top-ranked team, uplifting for the Canadian crowd. You're watching the 2003 MasterCard Skate Canada International on TSN. The men are up next.